Each day, almost 2 million Americans take to the skies, and all depend on aviation professionals to get home safely. Hello, I'm Adam Shapiro.
And a good morning to you, Maria. Everyone here, of course, now preparing for the next move in all of this. Angela Merkel, the chancellor in Germany, issued her statement roughly 45 minutes ago, and she was very specific. They have a word, actually, in German, Einschnitt, which means break or like a cut, and this is an historic break, and they're preparing.
And when you look at the numbers and how tight the race is right now in Florida, I mean, it's neck and neck. Hillary Clinton barely has, according to the average of polls from Real Clear Politics, a one-point lead.
And it's about to get worse in Hazard, where one coal company just notified miners, more than 100 of them, may lose their jobs April 1st.
And that has been flipping back and forth Democrat-Republican this election cycle. So to wrap this up, Stuart, you know, the Democrats won what's called the I-4 corridor.
This is an industry, according to Jeffrey Miron, the respected Harvard economist, that legally and illegally totals $20 billion every year nationwide.
Geologists say there are 493 trillion cubic feet of gas trapped in the ground below me right now. It's worth hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars, but nobody around here can tap into it. Go 10 miles that way into Pennsylvania? They can. In a coal mine deep below Hazard, Kentucky, miners like Gary Combs face a dark future.
I've got hundreds of friends that's been laid off, and they went out west to try to get jobs, and they worked for a while, but unfortunately, things out there didn't work out neither, so.
Kentucky is the nation's third largest producer of coal, but competition from cheaper natural gas and tough new EPA regulations on coal-burning power plants have thrown thousands of coal miners out of work. Close to 20,000 mining jobs have been lost since President Obama first took office, almost 7,000 of them in Kentucky. Unemployment in Hazard and the surrounding county is 9.4% and spreading. Josh Sale was just laid off from his trucking parts job.
The hardest thing about this is when your kids cry and they want to know if you're going to have as much money, Daddy. And what do you tell them?
It was 1977. The United States was in the middle of the energy crisis, and President Jimmy Carter delivered a speech to the nation in which he said we needed to shift to coal in order to power our country. Well, we did. More than 1 billion tons a year was produced, but now coal production has fallen. It's less than 900 million tons a year.
It's a day-by-day thing. You don't want to buy nothing right now, you better save every dime you got, because, you know, it's going to get rough.
Let's take one. Nice look, son.
It already is, according to young people in Hazard who don't see any future for them in the home they love.
Everybody's moving away. You see businesses that you was, you know, going into as a child, and you remember the people by name, and then you blink, and a year later, they're gone.
And it's about to get worse in Hazard, where one coal company just notified miners more than 100 of them may lose their jobs April 1st.
In remote and tiny Loyalton, California, 71-year-old Patsy Jardin just learned her monthly pension is being cut 60%.
How am I going to make it now? What am I going to do?
Patsy worked 34 years for the city of Loyalton, but her pension, once $49,000 a year, will now drop to a little more than $19,000.
Just scary that they can do this.
Fellow retiree John Cousins got the same letter.
By 60%.
From the California Public Employees Retirement System, or CalPERS. Patsy and John are among the first retirees ever in CalPERS history to have their pensions cut, and critics warn they won't be the last. Spokesman Brad Pacheco says, don't blame CalPERS.
The city of Loyalton defaulted on their retirees. They made a bad decision, and those retirees are going to suffer for it.
Loyalton pulled out of CalPERS 3 years ago. Its pensions only 40% funded.
Who was watching out for you?
Nobody was.
Bad investments have cost CalPERS billions of dollars needed to cover pensions for almost 2 million people. The debt right now, $164 billion and growing.
We're paying out more in benefits, than we're taking in contributions.
Right now, CalPERS is selling assets to cover the shortfall, but none of that will help John or Patsy.
I think we're just the ones that are going to pay for this.
An example for all of California.
Yes, for all the retirees.
CalPERS insists its pension fund is healthy, but critics say that's not entirely true, especially when you consider the thousands of cities and municipal entities which pay into CalPERS. That's why the retirees here in Loyalton say what happened to them could happen to anybody. The road to prosperity runs through Conklin, New York, but people here say the good times keep passing them by.
Oh, struggling, depressed.
Kenny Brown grew up in the rustic area where unemployment runs high, and 17% of the people, more than the state average, live in poverty.
There's barely jobs left. There's no one left to spend the money, and we need something to bring money in and to bring people in to stay in the area.
That something is fracking. But New York Governor Andrew Cuomo recently banned high-volume fracking, despite estimates it would create 15,000 to 18,000 desperately needed jobs. Geologists say there are 493 trillion cubic feet of gas trapped in the ground below me right now. It's worth hundreds and hundreds of billions of dollars, but nobody around here can tap into it. Go 10 miles that way into Pennsylvania? They can.
Montrose is getting new streets and water lines and everything else, and up here, nothing's going on.
New York's fracking ban rubs Al Fortunato the wrong way. Fracking created 30,000 jobs in Pennsylvania and is forecast to add $26 billion to the annual economy by 2020. And that's something Fortunato says Cuomo can't ignore.
He needs to pay more attention to the southern tier and forget about New York City. Really. And get some money income up here and help us out.
For now, the only digging anyone can do in Conklin is to clear a path for the future. Adam Shapiro, Fox Business.